Once again, welcome all of you. So yesterday lecture we have discussed what are the transmission impairments, types of the transmission impairments, where we have discussed about the attenuation, noise, as well as distortion. And at the end of the lecture we have discussing the noise actually. And in the noise we have discussed various kinds of noise like thermal noise, intermodulation noise, crosstalk, and last one was the impulse noise. So impulse noise was remaining. To start with this topic, impulse noise is what? Impulse noise is nothing but it is a non-continuous consisting of regular irregular pulses or noise spikes for the short duration or relatively high amplitude. Okay. So this is why this kind of the problem would be occur in the communication system. It is generated from because of various causes like external electromagnetic disturbances such as lightning, faults and flaws in the communication system. That's why it is also suggested that during the lightning or the heavy rain conditions to avoid the use of the telephone network. Because of this situation, if these irregular pulses or spikes are generated, that could be hamper the quality of the signal. Okay, so this is the main reason impulse noise would be generated. So we have to be take care of that when we are using a communication system. And if you have to see, impulse noise is a very minor annoyance in the analog data, like a analog data voice transmission may be corrupted due to this short clicks or the crackles that is responsible for the impulse noise. So these four kinds of the noises are generally in picture when we are discussing about the communication system or the digital transmission or data transmission. So we have to be take care of that, and for that purpose there are the various improvements are also there in the communication systems are available nowadays that would be used to overcome the noise problems. Now, after this discussion of the impairments, we have to be moved to the next topic, that is nothing but a very interesting topic, channel capacity. We have used the word of the channel capacity in the last lecture also, or you can say it's a data rate limits. So we know that between the transmitter and the receiver, there is a channel through which the signal has been transmitted, and in this channel there is a possibility of addition of lots of the impairments like attenuation, like distortion, noises that already we have discussed. So how this kind of the impairments would be limit the signal property, maybe in terms of amplitude, maybe in terms of delay, maybe in terms of addition of noise factor or corruption of the signals, we have to be calculated with the help of such this concept of channel capacity. So what is the channel capacity? Maximum rate at which data can be transmitted over a given communication path or a channel under the given condition is referred to as a channel capacity. So what is the channel capacity? Channel capacity is nothing but maximum data rate at which the data can be transmitted. So data rate, how to calculate this, we have already seen, but we have to be in detail in this particular topic we have to be covered. So data rate, first of all, it is related to the data rate, and it is actually the maximum data rate. So on which factor the data rate depends, that is very much important before going to calculate the channel capacity. So these data rates are dependent upon three factors. First, the bandwidth available in the communication path. Second, the level of the signals we are using. We are generally using the binary data for the digital transmission, or in the means of the digital transmission where we use the binary 1 or 0. Okay, two levels are there. Maybe more than two levels are also possible. We have little bit discussed in the previous lectures. And the third one is the quality of the channel or the level of the noise induced in the channel. These are the three major factors that would be affect the channel capacity, or that would be limit responsible for limiting the data rate or data flow rate. Okay, so this is, these three are very important factor you have to be noted down: bandwidth, level of signal, and quality of the channel. Now, there are the two types of the channels we can consider. One is noiseless channel, another is noisy channel. So when we are talking about the noiseless channel, so it is also called as a Nyquist bitrate. Nyquist bitrate. Okay. So noiseless channel means what? What kind of the channels we can consider as a noiseless kind of channel? Let to see. For a noiseless channel, the Nyquist bitrate formula defines the theoretical maximum bitrate. Noiseless channel means there is no noise has been be added in this channel. When the data has been be passing through this particular channel, there is no noise, and such kind of the channel is called a noiseless channel. It is actually a hypothetical situation or the ideal situation. It is not practically possible that there is no noise in any channel, but for ideal condition, we have to be also calculate the maximum data rate, that is the channel capacity, and on the basis of that, further we have to be go for the practical calculation by keeping it as a reference point. So for the noiseless channels, Nyquist was the scientist that has been defined the bit rate formula for the, defining the theoretical maximum bit rate, and that was bit rate is equal to twice of bandwidth multiplied by the log base 2 L. Twice of bandwidth multiplied with the log base 2 L. So bandwidth, everyone knows that what is the bandwidth is. Bandwidth is the bandwidth of the channel. And here what is the L is? Capital L is representing the number of signal levels used to represent the data. Okay, number of signal levels. Generally we are talking about the digital data. So number of signal levels that represent the data, and bit rate is the bit rate in bits per second. So these are the three important elements to calculate the this bit rate, or maybe you can have to be calculate the bit rate. You have to be either calculate the bandwidth from the given bit rate, or maybe you have to be calculate the number of signal levels by given in the question as the bandwidth is given and bit rate is given. So these are the interchangeable variables are there that you can use any one of them. Okay. So here if you have to be see, according to the formula, we might think that given a specific bandwidth, we can have any bit rate what we want by increasing the number of signal levels. Okay, if you want to increase the bit rate, you have to be increase the number of signal levels, because bit rate is proportional to the log base to L. So signal level and bit rate are proportional to each other. Similarly, the you can increase the bit rate by increasing the bandwidth also, but generally it is not possible. For any communication system, there is a fixed bandwidth are there, or specific bandwidths are there. For that you have to be calculate the bit rate. So you have to be one of the option that you have to increase the number of signal levels. When we increase, but when we increase the number of signal levels, there is a additional burden on the receiver, because at the transmitter side there is not a that much amount of signal levels, and when we have to be passed through the channel, we are increasing the number of signal levels. So it would be provide one additional burden on the receiver. That is also practically a little bit difficult to implement. So we have to also take care of this kind of the situation when we are dealing with the increasing the signal levels. So what kind of the, if the number of the levels is just two, receiver can easily distinguish it is a binary zero or it is a binary one. But if the level of the signal is higher than the two, maybe four, maybe eight, or maybe here it is mentioned as the 16, receiver must have to be very sophisticated to distinguish between the 64 different levels. Okay, so as the number of signal levels increases, the job of the receiver would be increased. The distinguishing between the this 64 levels is very difficult task. So that is solution also, and from this solution there is some issues are also raised. Now we have to see some numericals based on this particular concept, and that is the concept of the to finding out the channel capacity for the noiseless channel. So this is the first problem that we have to solve it. I have already told you to keep ready with the notebook and the pen. So what is the question? Very simple question. Consider a noiseless channel with bandwidth of the 3000 hertz transmitting a signal with two signal levels. What is the maximum bit rate? A straightforward formula based question. One thing you have to be considered, two signal levels. Bandwidth is what? 300 hertz. So what would be there? Answer is what? Oh, very quick, one answer is coming. Monali Bhangre, 6000 bits per second. Correct answer. 6000 bits per second. Now you can see what is the solution is there. The maximum bit rate can be calculated as the formula of the bit rate is equal to twice of bandwidth and twice of 3000 into log base 2 and the number of signal is Pansare Kaveri. It is also correct. Log number of levels are what? Number of levels are here. Number of levels are 2. So you have to be L is replaced by the 2 and log base 2 2 is 1. So 6000 bits per second, that is 6 kilobits per second. Very simple problem. Now I will be take the same problem, only I have to be modified number of signal levels in the next example. So solve it is also. Now same noiseless channel that we have considered for the example 1.19, but here only the difference is what? Number of signal levels is now 4 instead of 2. We are using number of signal levels 4, means each level would be, we have to be send the 2 bits. In the previous case we simply send the signal as a 1 0, okay, in the previous example. But now in this example we have to be take one level for 2 bits like this. So we have to be solve for this. What is the now maximum bit rate? Is it would be increased or it would be decreased? Tell me, solve it. Chitrekha Rahane, solved. Monali Bhangre, 12000 bits per second. Pansare Kaveri, decrease. No, it would be increased because your signal levels, per level is number of bits are increasing, so your bit rate would be also increasing. Chitrekha Rahane, Sradha Rahut, all are correct. 12000 bits per second, because a single level previously carry only 1 bit. Now a single level is carrying the 2 bits. Neha Navle, also correct. So it is increasing the bit rate. You can see from the formula. It is a very simple solution. Twice into 3000 into log 4 now. Log 4 means the value is 2. So 2, it would be double. So the bit rate would be double. As we double the number of signal levels, your bit rate would be also double. So this is a relationship, very interesting, because I have already told you that the signal level is proportional to the bit rate. So as the signal level doubles, the bit rate would be also double. So data would be moved more faster than this. Now the next question based on the same concept. This was the last question based on the same concept. Maybe. Example 1.21. We need to send 265 kilobits per second over a noiseless channel with a bandwidth of 20 kilohertz. So how many signal levels do we need? So here bit rate is mentioned already. Here the bit rate is mentioned. And what is the bit rate? Bit rate is mentioned as a 265 kilobits per second over a noiseless channel. So same formula would be used. Bandwidth is also mentioned, 20 kilohertz. So it is very simple to solve now. So what will the answer is there? Tell me the answer. Tell me the answer. What is the answer is there? Very simple problem. Same formula. You do not need to change any formula either. What is the answer? Signal levels you have to be find out. How many signal levels are there? Anyone? Same formula you have to be used. See, answer is not coming, so I am just do not waste the time. See, this is your bit rate. Okay, bit rate is on the LHS side. 265 means 265 multiplied with that 1000 kilobits per second. And then the right hand side twice of bandwidth, then 20,000 because 20 kilohertz is there. And log base 2 L. L is what? Your number of signal levels. You have to be find out in this question, this L is there. Okay. So, what is the next step? Just divide it with 265,000 divided by the 40,000. You would be get a 6.625. Now, find out the L, what we have to be do? Anti-log of 6.625, or either you have to be take L is equal to 2 the power 6.625, and that means the answer would be what? The answer would be this particular level, 98.7 levels. Is it clear? Is it clear to all of you? 45 students are there.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir. But what is the problem with this solution? Can anyone has any doubt, any issue regarding this value of the levels? We are dealing with the digital data that is having the basic two levels, 0 and 1. So what is the problem with this? Is this the solution, or can we transmit this kind of the levels in the with the digital signal? No. So because it is not a multiple of the two, we have to always decide the levels in types of the multiple of the two. So if you have to be see what is the nearby multiple of two number would be there, means we have to be considered 2 the power n. So 2 the power 4 is 16, 2 the power 5 is 32, 2 the power 6 is 64, to the power 7 is 128. So this is the level residing between the two. Either there is a 6 levels or either there is a 7 levels present in the signal. So for that purpose, you have to see the explanation is what? Since this result is not a power of 2, we need either to increase the number of levels or either decrease the bit. So if we have the 128 level, more than 98.7, so means bit rate is 280 kbps, or if you would be decrease the bit rate, so you have to be the decrease the number of levels, 64 levels, so bit rate is to the 240 kilobits per second. So this 265 kilobits per second would be generate a level 98.7 levels, but we know that we generally transmit in the power of 2, so it would be either 128 levels is required or either 64 levels are required as per the requirement of your application. Okay, so these are the some examples that we have to be generally numericals come in this particular topic. In same, the numerical of 4 marks would be there related to this topic. Now come to the second kind of the channel, that is also very important topic is there, noisy channel. Till we have discussed about the noiseless channel, now we have done a noisy channel. In reality, we cannot have a noiseless channel. Channel is always noisy. This is the practical truth. So in 1994, Claude Shannon introduced a formula called the Shannon capacity to determine the theoretical highest data rate for a noisy channel. So what is the formula for the noisy channel? The capacity. In that case, we have used the data bit rate. That is also the formula of capacity actually. So bit rate or the capacity here we are using word for noisy channel. The capacity of the noisy channel is equal to bandwidth into log base 2 1 plus SNR. What is SNR? Anyone? Elaborate the term SNR.
Anyone? Signal to noise ratio.
Signal to noise ratio.
Ratio.
Okay. So here SNR could be either a number because it is a ratio, or either we have to be represent it in terms of decibel. Okay. Both are terms are used frequently. In this formula, bandwidth is the bandwidth of the channel, SNR is the signal to noise ratio, and the capacity is the capacity of the channel in bits per second. So here the capacity would be represented in terms of again bits per second. Like data rate, we have represented bit rate, we are representing the bits per second. Here also the capacity is represented in terms of bits per second. Now, to solve the numericals based on this, so the idea would be more clear. Consider an extremely noisy channel in which the value of signal to noise ratio is almost zero. In the other words, noise is so strong that signal is faint. So find out the channel capacity for such kind of the noisy channel. So here very important term is given, signal to noise ratio is zero. So you have to find out the channel capacity C. So what is the solution? Very simple, C is equal to bandwidth into log base to 1 plus SNR. What is the channel capacity? Straightforward. If you have not note down the formula, note down this formula. Capacity is bandwidth into log base to 1 plus SNR. And now solve this problem. Okay, one has given the solution, two has given the solution. Signal to noise ratio, Monali Bhangre, correct answer. Good, Monali. It is zero. It is very simple. SNR is proportional to the capacity. So it is zero. Pranali Shishagar, zero, correct. See the solution, very simple. What I am feeling that lots of the students are not taking participation in the lecture. It is a, you have a laser in your home that you have to be, no one is looking like the classroom, you have to be taking not a participation. But I am requesting that you have to be take a participation. So very simple concepts are there. So first unit will we give you very good marks for your NSEM also. It is very interesting topic for students. So C, capacity is bandwidth into log to 1 SNR. 1 plus 0, SNR is here 0. So log 1 is 0. So your capacity is 0. It is already mentioned. It is extremely noisy channel. So capacity is 0. No signal would be passed. Whatever signal would be passed, it is completely noisy, faint signal. You at the receiver end, you will be not able to retrieve the actual signal. This means the capacity channel is 0 regardless of the bandwidth. In other words, we cannot receive any data through this channel. Our bandwidth kitna bhi increase kar do, but you would be not able to receive any signal data. Now, next problem. We can calculate the theoretical highest bit rate of a regular telephone line. A telephone line normally has the bandwidth of 3000 Hz and the signal to noise ratio is usually 3162. Practical issue problem. This is the practical problem of the basic landline telephones. So it is having the bandwidth of 3000 Hz, 3 kilohertz, and the signal to noise ratio is 3162. So find out the channel capacity. Find out the channel capacity for this. Now the 5 minutes is the remaining. Please, by anyone, take the attendance as a screenshot. Ranode Sarika, are you present? You please take this. Only one or two students, please take. Do not go everyone. Sarika is present, so please take the screenshot and send me personally on the WhatsApp. From the next week, we will be start the Google form for the attendance. Okay, what is the solution? Oh, 3, 4, 8, 8, 1. Okay, everyone is giving the same solution. 34.88 kbps or 34,881 bits per second. Correct. See, very simple straightforward problem is there. So where this is the solution. 3000 bandwidth log 1 base to 3163, that is 11.62 multiply 34,860 bits per second or 34.86 kbps. The highest bit rate for the telephone line is 34.86 kbps. If we want to send data faster than this, we can either increase the bandwidth of the line or improve the signal to noise ratio. So this is the internet speed rate basic for all the telephone networks. If you want to increase the speed, then you have to increase the bandwidth, or either you have to increase the signal to noise ratio. Now solve the next problem based on a similar topic. The signal to noise ratio is often in decibel. Assume that SNR dB is equal to 36 and channel bandwidth is 2 megahertz. Find out the capacity. This kind of problem is asked in the exam. SNR is given in decibel, but as per formula we have calculated it in the linear scale, not in the decibel scale. Bandwidth is also mentioned. So you have to be first convert SNR dB into the linear SNR, then and then only you would be able to solve this problem. Okay, so just convert it. First you have to be calculate SNR dB. What is the formula for SNR dB into linear SNR? Signal to noise ratio, it is the power term. So the formula is what? 10 log base 10 SNR. SNR dB is equal to 10 log base 10 SNR. So tell me, what is the value of SNR first? Then we have to move for the further. This is very good, tricky question. This kind of problem is asked. 3981 is the SNR. Okay, correct. 3981 is the SNR. And what is the capacity? Capacity is what? In Mbps, capacity would become in Mbps. This is the formula for SNR. It is displaying in the screen. 24 Mbps. Very good. Correct. Monali has solved it. SNR in dB. We have to first calculate the linear SNR, then put up in the formula of capacity, channel capacity. 3981 is the SNR. 23.91. It is also correct nearby. Okay, see the solution. C is equal to B log 2 1 plus SNR 1 plus 3981. That is this. And finally, the solution is 24 Mbps is the solution. Okay. So this is this kind of numericals would be asked generally in the examination. Those who have not solved, please note it down. So channel capacity would be carry a numerical. So it is a very good chance to achieve a number in the examination of NSEM. 4 mark question is definitely from this particular section. There is only 2 formulas, bit rate and channel capacity. Now see the another problem. For practical purposes, when the SNR is very high, we can assume SNR plus 1 is almost the same SNR. When the SNR value is very high, you can consider it is simply SNR. So the new formula I am defining here for the capacity. If SNR is very much larger than 1, then this formula you can also use. Bandwidth into SNR dB upon 3. Here SNR is directly in the terms of dB. You can correlate with the previous problem. 2 MHz into 36 upon 3, 24 Mbps. But this formula is not always valid, only when the SNR is very high. Now time A is very less. Please take the attendance. And I am binding up the lecture here. Thank you. For the next lecture, we have to be learn the next topic, that is transmission media, guided and unguided media charges. Okay. Twisted pair cables.